Good morning to one and all present here. Today is the second day of the presentation and I welcome you all. I, Aditi Sawal from River Narmada.
I, Priyanshi Sawal from River Narmada.
Present you a presentation on the topic Johnson & Johnson baby powder case. There were some challenges in 2017 and 19 the Johnsons had to face regarding the baby powder. Starting with the introduction of Johnson & Johnson, it is an American multinational company and it is the largest healthcare company and it was started by James Wood Johnson, Robert Wood Johnson first, Edward Mead Johnson. That's why they named the company Johnson & Johnson. It was incorporated in 1886 in New Brunswick, New Jersey, US. It has 265 operating companies in 60 countries. The company mainly deals with three basic segments, that is the consumer, pharmaceutical and medical devices. The primary focus of the company is on the human health and its well-being. Its revenue for 2018 was 56969 crores approximately.
Now moving on to the major products of Johnson & Johnson, the very first one, it deals with pharmaceutical segments. That means majorly the products are anti-infectants, the cardiovascular, contraceptive, etc. Now next segment in which it deals with is medical devices. That means it deals basically in disposable contact lenses which are easy to use, professional diagnostics, biosurgicals, etc. Now, the other and the most used segment is the consumer segment, which basically deals with baby care products, mother care products, and etc. These are the few images of the products which are manufactured by Johnson & Johnson in all the three different segments.
This is the income statement. The black thing shows the revenue of the company. The blue thing shows the net profit of the company. Whereas the line shows the profit margin of the company. As you can see, there is a decline in the 2017 period. That was due to the baby powder case, which we will explain you later.
Now, few of the competitors of Johnson & Johnson are listed below, like Abbott, Bayer, Merck, etc. Now,
this is the explanation of the baby powder. It is the softest mineral is used in this, that is known as talc, and it does not generate any chemical reaction, and it easily absorbs in the body.
Now, moving on to the Johnson & Johnson case. Before moving on, I would like to draw your attention to a sentiment that when a baby is born, the first and the most important relation that it shares is always, lifelong, is with its mother. So, mothers are always cautious about what products they are using for the babies, what kind of food they are providing to their babies. So, that is why the case majorly came into news. The first cases of asbestos were found in the year 1972 to 1975. Moving on, what are asbestos?
Now let's understand what are asbestos. These are six naturally occurring fibrous minerals. In nature, they are soft, fluffy, flexible, and they are resistant to heat, electricity, and corrosion. These are used as an effective insulator, and it is also used in cement to make that strong in such products. The disadvantages of asbestos is it's highly toxic and it cannot dissolve in the body easy, so it causes cancer and it causes very rare cancer known as mesothelioma. Previous slide.
Yes, now
yes.
Yes, moving on, continuing with the case, then in year 2017, from year 1972 to 2017, there were almost 40,000 tax-related lawsuits that were filed against Johnson & Johnson. Then in December 2018, the Drug Control General of India came into action and they got involved in the case. Secondly, in January 2019, the Johnson & Johnson lost their case against the asbestos.
Next, please.
Yes, so the case study that was conducted by DGCI was that 22 women claimed that they developed ovarian cancer after using Johnson & Johnson baby care powder. Johnson & Johnson stated that as an answer to the first statement, Johnson & Johnson answered that they have shown that men and women have not developed any asbestos related disease. Further, it happened that Johnson & Johnson lost the case against asbestos.
It had to pay its customers 69 crores approximately. This is the market graph of 2018, where the market of J&J declined very tremendously. This was because of the case. People had stopped trusting Johnson & Johnson baby powder as well as in its other products. It led to their reduction in the product price. 3% declines in sales to rupees 5828 crore in the year ended March 2018. J&J growth has also slowed down comparatively 10 to 15%.
Yes, now there are some of the suggestions that came into news also that currently now people have stopped using talc that much and they have switched to cornstarch. There are other talc-free powders such as colon clay, arrowroot, baking soda, etc. are also into action. Some of the commercial baby powder alternatives are developed by Brute Bees Baby Dusting Powder, Nature's Baby Dusting Powder, and etc.
Thank you.
Yeah, these are some of the sites from where we got the data. Thank you.